Hey, Vinyl Community, it's VK here, back for another edition of V's Vinyl Lunch. And it's been a while since I've taken actually a walk out to Reckless Records or done anything on lunch. I've been kind of laying low on that, but over this past weekend, and I hope everybody had a great Thanksgiving here in the States. I hope everybody had a nice holiday and friends and family. I did go down and visit my wife's family in Southern Illinois, so I'll have a video up hopefully maybe over the weekend, some of the things I found down there. But I went today to Reckless Records that I usually do, and to pick up the monthly Illinois Entertainer. It's a monthly music magazine that I'm sure you guys have seen me show before. This month is featuring Panic at the Disco. I got a story on Gary Hoey and Sponge, so I'm looking forward to checking this out. And also feature some of the local bands and other bands that are coming here. There's something that I might want to check out here. In fact, I just saw this the other day. Where did it go? Right here. Coming in February at Mojo's, Zappa Plays Zappa. That might be kind of cool. Shooter Jennings. Might go check that out as well. Some good stuff coming up here, man. We'll see. We'll see. Maybe go with my buddy Jason. Jason Roth does videos, but he hasn't done a video in like 8 months, so I got to get on him. But check that out. So there's the Illinois Entertainer. And like I said, man, I've been kind of laying low with cash being we're getting into the holiday season. So, I really didn't go through too much of the bins over at Reckless Records. But I did find some stuff in their 50-cent bins. But first, a VC cheer, everybody, man. Hope you all have a good holiday season and everything. Drink up. And, today's lunch is brought to you by the VK Lounge and my wonderful chef, my wife Lisa, who's made some killer chili, man. Look at this. Oh, look at that, brothers. Look at the beans and tomatoes and things in there. I mean, my wife, Lisa, she makes the best chili, man, the best. I'll take it up against anybody's, man. It's good stuff, good stuff. Top notch. Top notch. All right. So let's get into it. Nothing to brag about here, really. Just kind of sharing. Haven't done a vinyl lunch in a while, so I did find a couple things. Like I said, man, give it for 50 cents. These are not, mint or some grail out there or anything. Just some, records just to kind of fill some holes, just, do some spins and see if I like it. And then, I can always go look for better copies. Starting it off, we got the Bodines, Outside Looking In. I believe this came out in 88. I had the original inner sleeve with it, and this is on, I believe, the 80s Reprise label, /Reprise label. I don't have any Bodines, thought, for 50 cents, or actually, technically, 49 there. Why not check it out, right? Here's another one that I didn't have, but, definitely wanted to check it out. Probably be looking for an upgraded copy, but this is Jeff Beck Group. Rough and Ready, and this is a plain inner sleeve, but this is on the original Yellow Epic label. So looking to check that out. The vinyl wasn't too bad, hopefully nothing too damaging. The cover has some little wear here and there, there's a little tape corner, but it's a starter, man. Might as well just grab it and check it out, and see if I want to hunt down a nice mint copy. Here's something else, too, kind of a little upgrade for me. This is Molly Hatchet's first album. I do have this at home, but my copy's pretty beat. Of course, I had an original, not original, but I had a copy from high school. And obviously, then, I wasn't really taking care that well of my records, I guess. Now, this one maybe helped me out, guys. This one doesn't have the barcode, but I do have the original inner sleeve. But it comes on the Blue Epic label. And not an orange. Now, knowing that this album came out in 78, I think that's just around the time Epic changed from the orange label to that label. Because it still has, on the front there, it still had the old Epic logo. So, I know LJ, you might know, was this on an orange label, the first pressings, or not? But, big Molly Hatchet fan. I love Molly Hatchet. So, it was cool to get this. Possibly an upgrade for my copy, at least. And I thought this was a nice little find right here. For 50 cents, this is United Artists Jazz. It's a comp of jazz musicians on United Artists, obviously. This came out in 1962, I believe. Where did I see that? Somewhere. But you know, check out some of the things on there. You got Billie Holiday, Herbie Mann, Art Blakely, Lloyd Myers, Bill Evans, Jim Hall, Danny Small. Not bad. I'll show you the label here. And nice thick heavy vinyl, you know. And there you go. Kind of nice, huh? Nice and real nice and clean. I mean, for fit, this is like, I mean, it's a VG for sure. And you know, I mean, the covers, you know, it's a white and kind of a cloth texture cover to it. So there's some dirt here. Maybe I can get that off, maybe not. But relatively, I thought it was pretty clean. So looking forward to that. Definitely, you know, get introduced to some new jazz things. Love stuff like this. You know, these comps. They're just cool, and you know, they were just limited releases. It's not like they kept these in stock after a while. You know, they put them out, and then they stopped pressing them when they had new artists come out. So there you go. So real quick, man, hope you guys enjoyed that little break there and the lunchtime action of your work day or work night or whatever you get to see this. I'm going to enjoy my chili. Scrumptious, delicious. Look at that. And take a swig of my Izzy. All right, cheers, everybody. Hope you're doing well, and I'll be showing a recent vinyl find coming up this weekend, hopefully, if I get a chance to shoot a video. And I'll tell you about my snake bite that I got. All right, take care.